We go now to the Summit for Democracy in the U.S. A Pinay youth leader voiced the disappointments of the younger generation on their limited influence in the upcoming 2022 elections. According to Linrose Jane Hinon of the Young Women Leaders for Peace, groups like Sangguniang Kabataan are not enough to effect change in the polls because of the lack of civic education. Around 30 million registered voters belong to the youth sector. She adds issues on access to technology and stable internet connection should be resolved. Meantime, Nobel Peace Prize winner Maria Ressa also stressing the importance of technology for journalists' search for truth.
The old gatekeepers, journalists, have just been replaced by the new gatekeepers, technology. And for some reason, we have allowed lies laced with anger and hate to actually spread faster and further than facts.
The camp of presidential hopeful Ferdinand Marcos Jr. apologizes for the heavy traffic caused by his caravan in Quezon City Wednesday. As Jackie Manaba tells us, the campaign sortie of Marcos and Sara Duterte tandem pushed through despite the lack of coordination with the local government.
Maraming salamat sa inyong pagdating.
A caravan of supporters of presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. and his running mate, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, triggered Carmageddon. Along Commonwealth Avenue in Quezon City Wednesday, the traffic mess was due to the failure of the event's organizer, lawmaker Mike Defensor, to coordinate with the Quezon City government. Despite the lack of coordination, Quezon City still provided assistance to the caravan by deploying traffic enforcers, medical on standby, and policemen. It took the caravan 3 hours to traverse Commonwealth and another 2 hours to reach the endpoint at Welcome Rotonda, the boundary between Quezon City and Manila. Defensor is also running for mayor of Quezon City. He previously claimed that incumbent Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte denied the Marcos Duterte tandem to conduct a campaign sortie at the Liwasang Aurora inside the Quezon Memorial Circle. But the local government asserts the group was not allowed to use the park because it is tagged as child-friendly and children are not yet vaccinated. Quezon City instead offered the QC Gymnasium. The Marcos camp apologized to motorists for traffic congestion caused by the caravan, saying they were overwhelmed by the number of supporters who showed up for the event. The Marcos camp also thanked the Quezon City government for deploying policemen, traffic enforcers, and ambulances. Partido Reforma, the political party of presidential aspirant Senator Panfilo Lacson, meanwhile criticized the mass caravan for causing massive inconvenience to the riding public and motorists despite December 8 being a holiday. The party urges the Interior Department and the Commission on Elections to take a look at the issue. Quezon City is the most vote-rich city in the country. Marcos and Sara's father, President Duterte, won there in the 2016 polls. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Interior Department to look into possible violations committed during the Marcos Duterte caravan in Quezon City. Interior Undersecretary Martindino says event organizers may be held liable for putting the public at risk as the caravan was a potential COVID super spreader. He also cited the massive traffic jams it caused. Dina says the Commission on Elections and Pandemic Task Force officials should also make a stand against this and other similar political gatherings.
Hindi ba nila naisip na isang tao lang ang positive dyan sa ano? Sa rally na o kung ano man yung inaano nila, magagamot ba nila? Pinakamalaking pananagutan nito yung kandidato. Kaya lang kami sa DILG, ang tinitignan namin dito yung organizer. Kasi yung kandidato, obligasyon niya ng COMELEC. Kayo nasa COMELEC, kung kayo may pagmamahal din sa ano, magsalita kayo. Kaya ngayon, ang interagency task force, dapat tignan nilang mabuti yan. kung kayo ay kung dapat kumilos ang interagency task force tungkol diyan sa bagay na yan. Palagay ko at obligasyon nila yan. At saka Department of Health, magsalita kayo.
While the Marcos Duterte tandem was parading around Quezon City on Wednesday, a new alliance was formed against the presidential candidacy of the late dictator's son. It includes opposition coalition Isambayan and presidential aspirant Leonie de Guzman. De Guzman says he's even open to possible unity talks with another opponent, Vice President Lenny Robredo, as he considers Bongbong Marcos their common enemy. But he insists he has no plans of backing out of the race to Malacañang.
Ayoko nang masyado pang pagsasagutin yung mga pwede ba para kasi pwede namang kaming dalawa o kung sino man ang makapag-usap at doon na namin detalyehin. Ayoko nang kasi pagka baka maging usapin ang Lenit Leo dito. Open akong makipag-usap. Sana ay magkaroon din ng klarong mga tindig doon sa issue ng mga mamayan.